Question 41. You complete development and testing of a new Canvas app. You add users to a security team and assign the security team permissions to the app. Users are unable to view the app. You need to ensure that users can launch and use the app. What should you do? Option A. Add the application to the solution. Option B. Publish the application. Option C. Share the application. Option D. Add the Power Apps Component Framework PCF control to the application. The correct answer is option B. Publish the application. Question 42. You are creating a Canvas app to enable users to order tickets. You create an input field for users to input the number of tickets to order. Users must order a maximum of 4 tickets and a minimum of 2 tickets. If a user enters a number except 2, 3, or 4, the input field must display in red. If a user enters the number 2, 3, or 4, the input field must display in green. You need to color the input field based on the user input. What should you use? Option A, formula. Option B, gallery. Option C, connector. Option D, calculated column. The correct answer is option A, formula. Question number 43. You are creating a Canvas app that will be used in several countries or regions. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. The first statement is, Canvas app authoring environment will adapt to the language setting of the author. The correct answer is yes. The second statement is, when running a Canvas app on a mobile device, the app adapts the app author's language. The correct answer is yes. The third statement is, numbers and dates in Power Apps app automatically conform to the regional and language setting for the user's device. The correct answer is yes. Question number 44. A company is creating a Canvas app to manage weekly status report from users about projects. Status report must be created weekly. Users can enter project tasks with description. Users can also add escalation requests for tasks that are late or at risk. When a status report is submitted with an escalation request, the app must automatically send a text message to the submitter's manager. A reminder must be sent at 8 p.m. on Sunday to everyone who has not yet submitted a status report for the previous week. You need to identify the appropriate component to use in the solution. What should you use? On the left-hand side, we have the implementation mechanism. On the right-hand side, we have the actions where we need to choose the correct implementation mechanism. The first action is automatically send a text message based on the report submission. The correct answer is triggers. The second action is automatically send a reminder at 8 p.m. based on a missing status report. The correct answer is conditions. Question number 45. A company is evaluating ways to connect Power Platform apps to external services to perform complex activities. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. The first statement is, you can create a Canvas app that scans and parses documents using Azure Cognitive Services and then adds the appropriate information to Dynamic 365 sales. The correct answer is yes. The second statement is, you can create a Canvas app that uses Azure Cognitive Services to read incident record and identify tickets that need to be escalated based on a sentiment score. The correct answer is yes. Question number 46. A company planned to use Power Platform to build apps which address specific business challenges. You need to recommend the appropriate types of Power apps to use. What should you recommend? To answer, select the appropriate option in the answer area. The first question is, field technicians need a mobile app to capture the location and the image of defective product. The correct answer is Canvas app. The second question is, sales representative need to see different views and dashboard in the sales app. The correct answer is model driven app. Question number 47. You create a model driven app for a department. You need to make the model driven app available to other department members. Which two methods should you use? Option A, send the application's web URL to other team member by email. Option B, use the share feature in the Power Apps Designer. Option C, publish the app to AppSource. Option D, deploy the application to other users' instances through PowerShell. The correct answers are option B, use the share feature in the Power Apps Designer. Option C, publish the app to AppSource. Question number 48. A company uses model-driven app for their mobile sales activities. The company wants to modify the view that is used for sales order. You must apply a new default filter to the view. You must also modify the default sorting for sales order. You need to make the changes to the view. In which three locations can you make the changes? Option A, Power Apps site. Option B, Solution Explorer. Option C, Microsoft Azure DevOps. Option D, App Designer. Option E, Microsoft Visual Studio. The correct answers are option A, Power Apps site. Option C, Microsoft Azure DevOps. Option D, App Designer. Question number 49. A company created the following Microsoft Power Platform environment to manage a custom model-driven app, development and production. You have been granted the system administrator security role to the development environment and a custom security role named project team member to the production environment. The first statement is, you will not be able to access the app until the system administrator security role is assigned to the app in the development environment. The correct answer is no. The second statement is you can delete record in the development environment. The correct answer is yes. The third statement is you will not be able to access the app until the project team member security role is assigned to the app in the production environment. The correct answer is yes. Question number 50. You are creating a module-driven app to track requests for codes. The app must use the following navigation structure. You have some options for sales and administration. You need to create the app navigation. Which sitemap component types should you use? On the left-hand side, you have the component types. And on the right-hand side, you have the navigation element where you need to choose the correct component type. The first navigation element is administration. The correct answer is group. The second navigation element is sales log. The correct answer is subarea. The third navigation element is customers. The correct answer is subarea.